Today's topic might be controversial for both photographers and clients, but I've really been meaning to make a video about this for a long time, so here it goes. A lot of people just want to know, why don't photographers give out their raw photos? What's the big deal? I mean, we just want a couple of photos. I mean, I paid for them, I should get them, right? It's not like you're gonna use them, they're just gonna like exist. As a photographer myself, I have been in the situation where a client does ask me, hey, can I have all the raw files? So what's the big mystery? Why don't photographers want to give their clients raw photos? Now, I'm gonna be speaking from a photographer's standpoint. Asking for raw photos from us, it's like asking an artist for their unfinished painting. You're essentially asking us for a product that isn't even finished. Raw files are not the final product. They are the raw materials we use to create a finished product. So it's kind of like building a house, you know? You need the bricks and the wood, but you're not gonna keep the bricks and the wood by themselves. You need to like put them together to create a beautiful house. Now, another reason is if another person sees these unedited photos from someone else, then any prospective clients might have a bad image of us, like, hey, is this really their work? Raw photos look like any other photographer could have taken them. They don't have your signature style or editing or lighting. Our editing and our post-processing is what makes us distinctive as photographers. That's what gives us our style, and that's why people book us. There's another thing I'm not sure that people understand. These files are actually camera raw files, and unless you have the proper programs and tools to open them, you'll get the files and you'll be like, you're not gonna know what to do with them. You really don't want to try to work around Photoshop. Like, you'll start crying. Giving our unedited photos opens the window for people to manipulate and edit our images without our consent. So I might give you my raw file, and then next week, you know, it's on Instagram and Billy Bob Jr. edited it using some filters from God knows where. It's like giving someone a rough draft of your script that you've been working on and then having them edit and add things in there and then releasing a final version. A lot of photos are purposely shot a little bit darker so that we can bring out details. So post-processing is almost necessary. It's crucial to get that final shot. When you're asking someone to give you a raw image and you open it up and it's all dark, you're gonna be like, wow, what a horrible photographer. But really our intent was to open it up and post-process it to our liking. So sometimes we don't want people to see how it looks like before processing, so people don't think that we're bad photographers. And from my own experience, I've had people get unedited photos, and let me tell you, they're usually not happy. I had a bride once get 2,000 photos from another photographer, all unedited, straight out of the camera, and let me tell you, she was not happy at all. There were people who were like holding her veil in the shot, and their hands were still in the shot, some random person's hands. It would be okay if it's, you know, Matt Damon's hands. Like I said, if it's Matt Damon, his hands, I will keep his hands cropped in there, but it's probably not Matt Damon. See, you want people to retouch that out. Here's an example of an unretouched photo from a wedding that I took. You probably think, hey, this isn't a bad photo. But let's compare it to the actual retouched photo, which is this one right here. You can probably see a huge difference in both the quality and the colors. Here are some other before and afters, just to give you an idea of the difference between unedited and edited photos. You have to remember quality over quantity. Would you rather have 150 beautifully retouched photos, or would you rather have 2,000 unedited, dimly lit, average looking photos? You tell me. If it were me, I'd want someone to retouch my face. I mean, this isn't perfect. I work on my own photos. You think I'm gonna take a picture of myself like this and put it out unedited? It's not happening. I've had an instance where there was a mosquito literally on someone's forehead in the picture. If someone gave you that unedited, would you be happy? A mosquito? You probably want that edited out. Another important thing is to just talk to your photographer. We're really not out to get anyone. It's not like, you know, we're on Facebook like, hey, I'm not giving you the raw files because I don't want you to be happy. Really not that at all. We don't have like a photography hit list and we're, you know, scratching off names, taking numbers and stuff. We want to make sure you love your photos as much as we do. And we don't want people judging us or having a bad image of us by seeing our unedited photos, because that doesn't reflect our finished product. We want to make sure that whatever people see in public is an accurate representation of both ourselves and our skills. We don't want someone seeing our unedited photos and saying, well, hey, why does it look like that? Usually Jessica's work is so much better. Why did she take that photo? We could lose clients who see those images and think, well, hey, I don't want my images to look like that. When in reality, they wouldn't look like that because those aren't our finished retouched pictures. It only takes one time for an unedited picture to hit the internet and then everyone sees it and then it's too late. Personally, for me, I wouldn't give out any raw files just because I'm pretty overprotective of my raw images. If you are a photographer and you really don't know what to do on that front, I would include in the contract that no unedited photos are to be given out, because if you don't include that in your contract, things could get a little messy. So definitely would add that in your contract. I actually have a video on contracts. You can check that out for more information. Let me know what you guys think about giving out raw photos in the comments, and thank you guys so much for watching.